First into the arena this year, when the Kennel Club celebrates 40 years of agility, we have our agility Staffords showing just how active, agile, bold and fearless they are. There are large numbers of Staffords now competing nationwide, and Avril and Joe run the Staffordshire Bull Terrier Agility League, which recognises their results. If you don't want to reach the dizzy heights of competition, Staffords love to learn, and do trees try a bit of agility training in your garden or at your local training club. You may be amazed at how much they enjoy it. They love to please people and most of all love treats, so you have two really good training tools. Our agility Staffords today are all red in coat colour, but Staffords can also be black, brindle, fawn, blue or white. Currently the majority of registered ones are blue, but let's not lose the other colours for their great diversity. Staffords, being only one of two breeds that mention suitability with children in their standards, we have Avril coming in shortly with her daughter Izzy, who is going to show off the rapport between herself and her dog Dakota. You can see just how quick these little dogs are, and they really do love this. We did have one year that didn't come out of the tunnel, it just kept running backwards and forwards. And this little dog is called Murray. Here's the combination I mentioned a little while ago. This is Avril with Izzy, who of course is our best handler. And the dog is called Dakota. See, Dakota said she's ever so bossy, Mum. Yeah, just check the bosses there. Get a treat for that bit. He says, Mum, she's being ever so bossy. That's it. Good instructions there, Izzy. And again, wait until you're told and you can have a treat. Big round of applause, please. Well done, Izzy and Dakota, and of course, Mum. Now, unfortunately, due to irresponsible breeding, we have a massive problem in Staffords with the bull breed mixes in rescue. Many of you will recognise Ali Taylor from ITV's For the Love of Dogs. Regularly, she stops Paul O'Grady from taking home all of the dogs. Squirt is a Battersea dog herself, living with a mixed bunch that have gone home with Ali over the years. Well, there's Squirt in the centre of the ring, showing you just how obedient this breed can be. Over here we have Danny, who turned Lewis's life around when he rescued him. Recently, little Whisper has also come to live with them. Whisper, as you can see, is very relaxed and does like having a tummy tickled. We are delighted to have some very special guests here today, the Street Vets. Street Vet was formed when Jade and Sam, both qualified vets, teamed up after they became aware of the breeds of the numbers of homeless people on the streets with their pet dogs. Street Vet consists of volunteer vet professionals giving their time to prevent and treat disease in the dogs of the homeless. They have a growing team working across London, Bristol, Cambridge, Brighton and Essex. Throughout the week, in all weathers, they're out on the streets with their backpacks, bonding with dogs and owners, offering meds, vaccination, blood and lump sampling, microchipping, as well as food, treats, toys and jackets for the dogs, a very large proportion of which are Staffords and other bull breed mixes. If the dogs need further investigation, they arrange for them to go to practices for procedures. Everything is achieved with a huge amount of generosity from vet practices, drug companies, animal welfare charities and local councils. They have an Amazon wish list and a website where you can make donations. They've made appearances on Channel 4 and The One Show, as well as across the whole of social media. Street Vet hopes to continue to expand and work with other organisations so that eventually those less fortunate and their best friends on the streets will have help nationwide. Can we have a huge round of applause for our street vets and our lovely rescue folk?
Okay, so thank you very much for that bit. Now, next up, we all know that 2018 is World Cup year for our footballers in amongst us, and our Staffords now would like to pay homage to the England football team. Now, we think we're going to need a little bit of magic to achieve this. So we have Darren here and our very own David Barkham entering the ring. Now, you might remember our magic box from last year. It made Blake disappear. We're going to see what he's going to achieve this year. So, I'm going to ask him to get up and in the box. He'll give you a little quick wave goodbye, I'm sure. Now, if we tuck him away in that magic box, of course, all magic needs a magic word. Darren should have his wand. I think the word should be Ingerland. So, one, two, three, Ingerland. Oh, wow. So, okay. David Barkham's disappeared and we have an England mascot. Okay, let's see if he can help us. So, let's leave our mascot on the side there and carry on with what we're going to do now. Now, of course, that having been done, if we're going to do some training and we're going to show some England trainers here, because we want them to do things right, we want them to make sure they've got all their muscles in place. We need to make sure, first of all, that our training ground is safe and secure in these worrying times. So you might remember last year we had Stella, the police sniffer dog that came from rescue with us. Well, our young man here, who for football purposes today shall be called Rio Ferdinand, is going to help us because he's learnt some sniffer training tricks too. So we have a motley crew here all lined up, waiting to go into our training ground and watch our England team. And of course, as with all grounds, we need to make sure it's safe and secure. We don't want anybody there with anything dodgy. Somebody looks a bit dodgy at the moment coming in. Right, okay, so I think it's time we brought in our sniffer dog to see whether or not there are any illegal substances being trying to be brought into our ground. So let's see if you can do your work here. Have a sniff. See if there's any smells you like. He looks a bit dodgy, that one. Well, you would think the vets would be all right, although I suppose they carry a few drugs, don't they? That one definitely looks dodgy. Oh dear, I think your game's up. Okay, can you escort our person off of the arena, please, so that we can get on with the next stage? We need to do some training now. So let's have now our footballers into the ring, please, and get them all in place. We're going to leave Sian in the centre of the ring here. She's our referee. Now, Sian, actually, some of you may recognise from the BBC Two programme, Me and My Dog, which is being repeated at the moment on Saturday afternoons. She's a wonderful dog trainer and she's helped us with everything we're doing today. We do appreciate it. Now, of course, there's always a senior on the team. So here we have, first of all, in the corner here, Gary Lineker. And he's going to show our team exactly what you need to do. Now, it's very important to warm up when you're doing things. And of course, if your teammates are about, you might need to give them a high five. Are we going to get a high five? Kind of like a high five. Now, they also need to do some sit-ups. And they're going to need to do some press-ups. But the most important thing is he spoke to his mate, Didier Drogba, and he told him, if you're anywhere near the penalty area and they come near you, go down like a ton of bricks. But I think, do you know what, Guri? You're about to get the first red card, yellow one. But you might even get a red card there. Off you go. Okay, so over here now, let's move on a bit. So now we have our next dog up into the training ring, and we have Stan Border Collymore. Now, of course, I'm going to show you how to develop those abs. You've got some very important ab work to do here. Get those muscles working a treat. Really hard trick to do, this one. So a nice bit of working on the abs. But of course, like we know, whenever you've been working hard and you've got your muscles warmed up, you then need to keep them warm. So we're going to get our dog here now to show you just how, after you've had your shower, to wrap up in your towel. That's it. Keep those muscles warm in your tracksuit. So off you go. Now, next up, we're going to do some very important leg work here. And we have our lovely little Robbie Growler, who's going to show you how to develop those leg muscles. So stepping up and stepping down. And some balancing. Really important to get your balance work going. All the way up and round, and down the other side. Very good. Nice control. Fantastic. Now, if you're working in defence, you also need to work very hard. You have to have a lot of control. So here we're going to have John Bones here showing you just how to work on your footballing control. So we'll do a little bit of leg weaving. And then we'll have a nice send away around the cone. Let's get some speed up. Oh, a jump as well. Okay, that's fine. Let's see if we can get there. A send away around the cone and a stop on the way back. That's it. And a lovely little recall. Thank you very much. Now, of course, all good football teams need a cheerleader. And here we've got young Daisy. She's the youngest on our team. So do bear with her. It's the first time she's been in a big arena. She's going to do a little bit of paw cheerleading. There, she shows you her paws. And as you'll see from her bandana, Daisy is a Wood Green rescue. Our team consists of some very well responsibly bred dogs and also some rescues. Well done, Daisy. Very, very good. Excellent. So, next up, you've heard us say already that at the moment coming into Crufts today, they're celebrating 40 years of agility. Well, what we're going to do next is something that's called hoopers, and it's a really good way of getting your dog working in hand with you, if we can get the course laid out right at first, of course. It's very fast, very speedy, non-contact, and we're going to show it here for the first time today. So we're just going to get these last few hoops out in place. And then a little dog here that we have, who is actually called Frank Lamppost, is going to race around our hoopers course. Are we there? We're nearly set. This needs a bit of thought to it. I did say it's the first time hoopers has been set out. Are we ready to go, Joe? Okay. Right, stand back and watch this little one speed. Now, if you like agility, but maybe your dog is too young to compete, or your dog is maybe older now and has joint problems, this is a really great non-contact sport to get involved with. As you can see, a lot of directional movement. So there you go. That shows you just a little taster of hoopers and a good bit of training as well. Now, next up, of course, it wouldn't be football without having a goalpost. We are going to need the goalpost in the centre of the ring now. And we're going to look and see if we can get some penalties done, because we all know that England always have a problem with penalties. So here we've got, coming into the ring, our young dog. And of course, he's the young gun of the moment. He is Harry Kane. So now he knows how to stop under control. Does he have his ladder? Do we know? Is the ladder about, or are we going to leave them? Maybe we're leaving the ladder out. I can't see the ladder anywhere. So maybe we'll go without and we'll just go. Oh no, here we are. See, because I can't see properly standing at the back. He's going to show you his ladder tricks. A lot of footfall going on, up and down. Working into that. And then we're going to get to take some penalties. So let's see, Harry. Let's put the ball on the spot and see if you can score. Well, that's typical England, isn't it, in penalties? We're going to have to do better than this. We'll try 2 out of 3. Well, that was 2. Let's go for a third. Take him back and see. That was nearly there. Oh, you're not on target today, Harry, at all, are you? Oh, well, never mind. Do you know what? If the young guns can't do it, I think we'll just have to get golden balls back into the ring. So, here, where did you find golden balls? Last we saw, he disappeared somewhere. He was having a cup of tea with Victoria and the kids. Okay, that's fine. So, if you want a dog that you can rely on to do this, let's get the penalty spot there. And let's see if we've got our hero of the day. Of course, all good goalkeepers have got to have a good pair of gloves. Got to check out the goalpost. Yeah, that looks about right. Get yourself in position. And he shoots. And he scores. Well done, golden balls. Absolutely fabulous. So, can we... Right, would golden balls like to show our very quick version of a Mexican wave? And thank you very much today, ladies and gentlemen. If you think it's all over, it is now.